morning, students. Students, are you hearing my voice?
Yes, sir.
You are right. Okay, so in the last class, some of the things regarding sources of medieval India, particularly about Delhi Sultanate, basically. Okay, so we had covered certain secular aspects, secular sources by which you know some of the things about Delhi, society of Delhi Sultanate, and economy and political and cultural aspects particularly. Okay, so today we'll continue that same class. We have to go through some of other sources, particularly Arab, the works by the Arab travelers and the Central Asian intellectual class which entered in Indian territories and spent their the major life in the Indian territories. Okay, so before going to my lecture, I have to share my PPT first of all, and then I'll continue my lecture. Okay, students, are you getting my screen?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, okay, right. Okay, so Delhi Sultanate, before going to this period of Delhi Sultanate, we have to see what we discussed first of all as a part of objectives, and to know more about the dynasties which ruled over the Delhi before the Mughals or Mughal dynasty, and to know the social and economic developments of Delhi Sultanate period, and to know about administration of Delhi Sultanate, particularly how they followed certain administrative setup during the time of Delhi Sultanate, and as a part of administration, we have to know about the number of officials who worked and how the administration division has taken place, like as a part of decentralization of the administration. Okay, so all these things we'll know while following such things about Delhi Sultanate. And we have to know the reasons for the downfall of Delhi Sultanate, and we'll conclude the part of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so before going to all this, we already discussed something, certain sources, and I will also continue the same sources, and I will give you some of the summary how what the things we are going to discuss. Okay, so you are well aware. Published by Qutbuddin Theory, and it means succeeded Qutbuddin Aibak, and later he was succeeded by his daughter Rajia Sultana, and then Balban was next important to Sultan as a part of Mamluk or slave dynasty. Okay, so then the Tughlaqs came to the power, and not the Tughlaqs, then Khiljis came to the power, and where during the time of Khiljis and Alauddin Khilji, Ghiyasuddin, Alauddin Khilji, who was the prominent personality among the Khilji dynasty, within the period of Alauddin Khilji, you are well known that a number of reforms has initiated as a part of military and revenue and market. Okay, so overall the performance of Alauddin Khilji, which reflected in the fulfillment of treasury. Okay, so during the Khilji's time, this treasury is somewhat full, and when compared to the other dynasties. Okay, so then Tughlaqs came to the power, and among the Tughlaqs, Muhammad bin Tughlaq and Firoz Shah Tughlaq was two important personalities. And during their times, you also see some of the reforms, particularly during the time of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. You will see certain reforms like introduction of the token currency, and he tried a lot to introduce some of the new currency system in India, apart from the traditional system of currency. And during his time, to enhance the financial setup, he also increased some of the land revenue, particularly in the Dobe region, Ganga Yamuna Dobe region. And he tried to transfer the capital from Delhi to Daulatabad. This also finally failed. Okay, so certain things you will see during the Tughlaq's period. Okay, so then the Syeds came to the power, and after the Lodis came to the power, and among the Lodi, Ibrahim Lodi was important ruler better to be called as the last ruler of Delhi Sultanate, who defeated by Babur in the battle of Panipat, the first Panipat, in 1526. Okay, so like things you definitely see while moving with Delhi Sultanate separately. Okay, so after that, before going all these things, we have to have some things over the sources, and the better sources to know about Delhi Sultanate was Al-Biruni's Tarikh-e-Hind, and which give you a lot of things about this Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so apart from that, there are other sources like Ziauddin Barani's Tarikh-e-Firozshahi and Patwai, Jahandari, and then Abu Bakr's Kufi's Chachnama, and Muhammad al Uddi's Kitabul Lamini, and Minhas Siras Tabakat Nasiri, and Ibn Battuta's Kitabul Rehla. Okay, so all these are important source. Not only these, there are many other source material in the Persian language. You found abundant material basically. And apart from these, I will give you some more literary sources, particularly with the foreign accounts, which they provided such material to know about things of this Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so one is the Hasan Nizami's Tajul Matir deals with the history of sultans from Muhammad Ghori to Iltutmish, and Minhas Siras Tabaqat Nasiri, which covering early Sultanate period, which is written in a simple style. And then the Amir Khusro was a gifted poet, and his five divans, four historical matnavis and two prose works throw light on the political and topographical and social cultural aspects of particular society of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so apart from that, there are other works of Amir Khusro, like Miftahul Futa and Kajanul Futa and Tarikul Tariki Alai. Okay, so and Tughlaqnama, which contains a valuable information on the political history of the reigns of Alauddin Khilji and Ghiyasuddin Tughlaq. Okay, so like you see, Amir Khusro was one of the poet, musician, lyricist. He was a multifaceted personality who provided such a things regarding the society of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so not only his historical works, and many other literary works, like the which is in the form of prose and poetry, give you a lot of things regarding the cultural aspects of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so apart from that, there are other important writers like Ziauddin Barani. Ziauddin Barani, one of the important historian, his works also gives you a lot of things regarding Delhi Sultanate. This Ziauddin Barani's the Tariki Firoshahi, which is continues the work of Minhas Chronicle, and Tariki Firoshahi, which deals with the political history from the reign of Balban to the first 6 years of Firoz Shah Tughlaq. Okay, so the Barani's concept, basically the Barani's concept of history was governed by practical, theological, and certain religious purposes, and he had his personal fads with fads, and as a fascination for the Turkish terminology used in the Persian literature, and he had an equal interest in the politico religious philosophy of his state, which found expression in his work Patwahi Jahandari. Okay, so Patwahi Jahandari, a important work of Barani, which gives you things about Delhi Sultanate. And another writers like Fakir Mudabir. Fakir Mudabir's Adabul Harb, also a equal valuable work for the study of the medieval political thought. Okay, so another one is the Isamis. Isamis Utahassi Salatin, which is an epic comprising the deeds of Muslim rulers, particularly in India, from the time of Muhammad of Ghazni. Okay, so Muhammad of Ghazni to Tughlaq times. And another one is Samsuddin Sirat Atif. So work Tariq-i-Firoz-Shahi. Tariq-i-Firoz-Shahi, which is sketches of the Tughlaqs, Tughlaq rulers like Ghiyasuddin and Muhammad bin and Firoz Shah, had traces the history down to the saga of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so Delhi by the Timur, up to the attacks of the Timur, you'll see certain things from this work, Tariq-i-Firoz-Shahi by the Isan. Okay, so and another one is Muhammad Sirhindis. Muhammad Sirhindis, Tariq-i-Mubarak-Shahi. Tariq-i-Mubarak-Shahi also records the main military and political events from the early Turkish period, which is I think up to 1435 AD, like that. And it is the main source for the study of history of the Sayyid dynasty. Okay, so this is the main work by which you know much things about the Sayyid dynasty, which is nothing but Muhammad Sirhind's Tariq-i-Mubarak-Shahi. And another one is Ali bin Muhammad al-Kirmani, which is better to be called as Sihab Hakim. Sikam Hakim's work, Matir-i-Muhammad-Shahi. Matir-i-Muhammad-Shahi is an official history, which is based on the official state papers and documents of the period of Muhammad Shah Khalji. Okay, so Khalji one. Okay, so and another one is which gives you lot of things, Amir Hassan's work, Fahadul Fath, and Sheikh Hamiduddin Naguri's Sarur-us-Sadur, also another work. And another one is Maulana Hamid Kalandar's Khairul Majlis, and other works like these are certain works which gives you a lot of things regarding the times of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so these things totally in the language of Arabic, and apart from that, there are many other things which gives you a lot of things regarding the Delhi Sultanate period. Okay, so apart from that, you are well known that many archaeological coins and monuments also you'll see, because there are certain live examples you see. Okay, so like you find number of coins and certain form of inscriptions also you find at various monuments, which still you find. Okay, so Qutub Minar, one of the living example about this Delhi Sultanate's great architecture and their cultural traits. And Ali Darwaza, also another important monument you'll still know. Okay, so you'll see. And apart from that, like certain tombs, Tughlaq Shah, Shikandar Lodi's tomb, you also still alive. And certain mosques like Qutb-ul Islam Mosque at Delhi, and Daidin Ka Jokra at Ajmer, which gives you a lot of a style, architectural style, which followed by this Delhi Sultanate. And also these monuments also gives you how the revenue and the financial status of Delhi Sultanate maintained. Okay, so all these are certain things you will get by following certain sources. Okay, so apart from these, you also know certain things like today I will give you before going to these various dynasties. First of all, I will you are while moving with the Delhi Sultanate period, you definitely know certain dynasties like Slave Dynasty and Khalji Dynasty and Tughlaq Dynasty and Syed Dynasty and Lodi Dynasty, like that. Okay, so these are the major dynasties, and within these dynasties, these major dynasties, you find one or two important rulers who played a important role during the development of various aspects during the time of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so, and I will try to give you some more examples, some more things regarding Delhi Sultanate, sources of Delhi Sultanate, and I will end up my class. And first of all, I will share one more thing, and then I will okay, so I'll try to finish by giving some of the other sources, and I will end up my class. And these are archaeological and inscriptions and monuments you will find, and many inscriptions were found found on coins, monuments, mosques, temples, places, etc. And milestones and tombstones also you find, and most of the inscriptions are in Sanskrit, Persian, Arabic, Hindi, and other languages. Some of inscriptions have both Arabic and Sanskrit language used, and these inscriptions gave a lot of information about the political, society, culture, religion, and administration seen during this period. And some of inscriptions describe the gifts given to religious and charitable institutions, and one among them is the Pehowan inscription suggests that Delhi was founded in 736 by Tomaras, and they had ruled over Haryana region with Dillika as capital. And another inscription is that Sarban inscription, which gives you information about Delhi during the rule of Muhammad bin Tughlaq. Okay, so such inscriptions also you will see. And apart from that, the rulers of Delhi Sultanate built many monuments in India. It gives us a lot of information about them. The style that Turks brought in India had four main characteristics. You are well known, like the dome, minaret, arches, certain roof structures. Okay, so these are certain structures which during the Delhi Sultanate they constructed. Okay, so this is better to be called as the style of architecture which followed by Delhi Sultanate. And Qutbul Islam at Delhi, which is Qutb Minar, which is as a part of Qutb Minar, and which is important monument still alive at Delhi. And apart from Alai Darwaza, which is one of the important construction during the time of Alauddin Khilji, also a live example you can see now. And another one is Adai Dinkar Chopra, which is at Ajmer, which is constructed during the time of Qutbuddin Aibak, one of the important mosque which you see by the Delhi Sultanate, and Jamat Khana Masjid at Delhi, which is also another important construction or the monument still alive, you can see at Delhi, which is also best example from the style, architecture style of Delhi Sultans. Okay, so Tughlaqabad Fort, which is you see some of the remains, not exactly you find, and some remains you find at Delhi, which is also constructed during the Tughlaq dynastic rule. And another one is Qutub Minar, and Qutub Minar, the style you see, and this is the architectural style you find on the Qutub Minar, and this is their pioneerial work for Delhi Sultanate, you see, particularly in the Qutub Minar. And we'll see all these things while moving in details, particularly about art and architecture of Delhi Sultans. Okay, so I will give you about their political aspects first of all, and then I will give you the things regarding the Delhi Sultanate by one section, one by one sections. Okay, so first of all I'll give you the political structure, and then I'll move to the society, and then I'll give you economy, then the religion, particularly about the culture, and finally the legacy, and finally I'll conclude with the downfall of Delhi Sultanate. Okay, so likewise I will give you about Delhi Sultanate while going with detailed lectures. Okay, so dear students, this is end of my class today, and I will give you again meet you in the next class at after the 11. And before end of my class, dear students, are you attended yesterday's session? Are you registered?
Yes, sir, registered.
Yeah, are you, how many of you got the certificates?
Sir, I got,
sir. Is there any student want to get the certificate? Today I will send the link again, and you can fill up the link, and giving by your feedback, you can get the certificate again, right? Okay, so evaraithe ninna participate chesi certificate raani vaallu evaraithe unnaro, so vaallaki ee roju 2 o'clock tarvata malli okka sari nenu aa link send chestanu. So ledha aa unna link meedane meeru feedback form fill up chesinatlayite mee mail ki aa certificate easy ga vachestund anamata. ఓకే సో ఎవరైతే సర్టిఫికేట్ కావాలనుకున్నారో సో వాళ్ళు ఆ ఫీడ్బ్యాక్ ఫామ్ ఫిల్అప్ చేస్తే మీకు సర్టిఫికేట్ వచ్చేస్తుంది రైట్ స్టూడెంట్స్ ఆర్ యూ హియరింగ్ ఓకే థ్యాంక్ యూ వెరీ మచ్ ఐఎమ్ ఎండింగ్ మై క్లాస్ ఐ విల్ అగైన్ meet you after 11.